Welcome back to the AR-12 Summer Showdown. This is the Elgato race number 3. If you missed it, in the last race we did, I had you guys driving the meme machine, the Volkswagen bus, with, let's just say, a very difficult tune to drive around. Today, though, we're changing it up a little bit. Today, we are driving this thing, the Elgato Cadillac Limo. Because today, we're in search of the ultimate limo driver. Oh, yes. Before I tell you about this challenge, though, I did want to tell you about Elgato, because the other day, Elgato dropped not one, not two, 7 new products. Some of which I can show you. Did you know there is a brand new Elgato webcam called the Elgato Facecam that they literally just dropped? If audio is more your thing, they drop this, the Wave XLR, which can power all of your favorite microphones. You might be saying, well, Nick, where am I going to place that microphone? How about on your new Elgato microphone arm? As per always, if you do want to check out our friends over at Elgato, click the link in the description. They make this series possible, and they make some really awesome stuff. Anyways, though, you're probably wondering about the Elgato race circuit for today. So let me show you it. This is where we're going today. It's going to start off fairly simple on the road. And then we're gonna jump into the airport where you've gotta navigate the shipping containers around the airport before you get some air over the jumps. After that, you'll do some high speed corners followed up by some slow speed corners. After that, you'll eventually arrive in Edinburgh for a couple more corners and the ultimate test of any limo driver, some quick reactions. And the person who can do that the best will be the ultimate limo driver. Did I mention that there's some off-roading in this? Oh, yes. There is some off-roading in this as well. Usually, I come in and I choose the class limit, but this time, I'm gonna let Twitch chat choose the class limit. So, Twitch chat, give me a number. The first number I saw is 8. We will start with 8. Then I see a 7 and then another 8. All right, class limit for today. S1 878 exactly. Go jump in your Cadillac limo. Go apply DJ's paint job and rejoin back outside the festival. You have 10 minutes to build your car. Good luck. Here's the thing for today's challenge, right? We're doing a little bit of everything from on-road to off-road, high speed to slow speed. So we need a car that can kind of do everything. By the way, we will be racing in the summer, so don't worry about snow tires or anything. However, right off the bat, I'm not gonna drive this thing front-wheel drive. We are gonna toss on all-wheel drive for the maximum grip. And then we do actually have a lot of different engine swaps, but which one do I take? Probably the Racing V12 because it saves a lot of weight. I'm gonna need to rev this thing out, but luckily we've got a big class limit to do some upgrades with. So let's get some racing tires on here. That is good for the grip. Let's also go for a front splitter and a rear wing because we do have a lot of corners and that is gonna help massively. I'm definitely gonna want some better brakes. This is gonna be like a maxed out limo. This is gonna be scary fast. I don't know if this is gonna be a good tune, but we'll go for it. We weigh 4,200 pounds, but we have over 1,000 horsepower, all-wheel drive and race tires. This is gonna be a pretty grippy vehicle. Anyways, let's see what everybody's running. So we've got race tires. Okay, everybody seems to be on, oh, these are snow tires. This guy, who's this? That's Fire. Fire is running the off-road tires. Okay, that's race tires. That's obviously race tires. That is snow tires. Okay, everybody's good. All right, fantastic. Everybody is already the class limit. So let's go start up this race today. This is the race circuit for today. 10 miles exactly, over 150 checkpoints. that start off in the center of the UK and head north. I am starting down in P11. Here we go for Elgato race number 3 in the Cadillac limos. Who is the ultimate limo driver? We are about to find out. So we've got tons and tons of downforce, 1,000 plus horsepower. Who can control these things the best? That is gonna be the question for today. So we're gonna head off into the airport almost instantly. And the brakes on my limo apparently don't work very well. A lot of people in their limos running wide on the opening quarter. And here we go into the shipping containers where you've really gotta slow it down around here. Very nice job. Good job improvising, lads. I move up to P5. Letzy is currently up in P1, followed up by Geet is Bald. That is Fire Prof Cargo's new gamer tag. Nicely done. Keep in mind, P1 moves off to the final, and that's an upside down limo. We move up to P4 with that one. Fire is just in front of us. Letzy still holding P1 and I run it wide. Oh my god. I think you can see what I mean by this racetrack will catch people off guard. If you relax for a second, this track will eat you up and spit you right out again. Anyways, let's catch up to Fire. We're closing in a little bit, maybe with a nice racing line. One guy runs it deep. Two guys running deep. We go up into P3 and into the podium positions as we've now entered the narrow part of this circuit as we close in on P2. Meanwhile, Letzy has a 13-second lead for P1. That is insane. Let's go. I would love to get P1. Whoa, and the P2! Totally! Wasn't paying attention, turned off the race circuit, and hands me P2 very, very nicely. Thank you. This racetrack takes no prisoners. I lack the horsepower to compete with Milo. Come on, close on in. I've got the downforce, no braking, no lifting. Come on. Man, this limo is actually so good. I don't have the confidence to send it. Now that I missed some early checkpoints, We're gaining. Nicely done. Let's go. Come on, Cadillac limo. We're doing really, really well. This is a battle of horsepower versus downforce. Come on. Milo runs it wide, takes a very nice racing line through the double roundabout. Very nicely dealt with there. Meanwhile, Letzy, an 18-second lead. We are getting destroyed out here. Come on, again, no braking. Nicely done. Milo taps the wall. Again, the better downforce wins through the corners. Let's go, let's go. We're not doing bad. And then we arrive in the off-road section of this racetrack, where again, it'll test your skills. If you were one of those people who chucked on the off-road tires, you are about to have a massive advantage through here. And I think Milo might have off-road tires. I cannot match that grip. I've got to go so slowly. That's okay. I'm losing some gap, but I should be able to make it up in the last 20% of this race. Come on. Come on, buddy. Here we go. Now we get into the streets of Edinburgh through another roundabout. Come on. This is what I need, that downforce. More than ever. Oh my god, my limo's on two wheels. There is, however, one more area of this racetrack, the quick reaction point, that might catch some people off guard. We'll see, but here we go down the main street of Edinburgh. Letzy has already taken P1, an 18-second lead. That is insane. Here we go, time for the quick reaction test. And I fail it. And I can't even rewind. No! No! Come on! Come on! I'm not even gonna get to the finish line. That is how far Letzi is in front. That was pure domination. Absolute top driving from Letzi in P1. I will gladly take it though. P3 piloting the long limo. Letzi, like I said, domination from start to finish. So Letzi was running race tires, no front splitter, but a big ol' rear wing on the limo. GG Letzi, the fan favorite, wins again, a grandmaster in Forza Horizon 4, moves off to the seventh and final race for a chance to win some awesome Elgato products. If you guys do want to sign up for race number 4, signups are open now on our Discord server. Links down below for that. And don't forget to check out our friends at Elgato. Check out all of their new products. They are super, super cool.